Hello, and today we will be a bit geeky and come back on quite some timepiece, the Zenith Academy Christophe Colomb. This watch was introduced already a few years ago, but we wanted to focus on its very, very original and magical rotating escapement module. Zenith only produces a few of these watches per year, so when we heard that they were about to assemble one, well, we jumped in our watchmobile and headed for the lock, just outside of La Chaux-de-Fonds in the Jura Mountains, to see this in person and meet the man and his team at the origin of this development, because we simply wanted to understand how it works. Before going into details, let me quickly come back on the original idea. As you've probably seen on the watch's TV, the quest for precision and the science of timekeeping in the 17th, 18th, 19th century has had a tremendous impact on the development of our societies. One of the best examples was mastering the seas, which seriously enabled to build empires, develop international trade and so forth. But to do so, you needed beforehand to master time. And that's the main reason why marine chronometers were the equivalent of the supercomputers of today. It was extreme high tech placed on board your ship. I know today it sounds a bit strange, but really that's what it was. Anyhow, not only these chronometers hold the finest mechanics inside them, but to further improve their accuracy, they were set on some kind of gimbal system which helped the clock stay as flat as possible in rough seas. So that's the main idea behind this timepiece. The watch itself is kind of the ship, your arm and its movement represents the rocking sea, and the entire escapement module stays as flat as possible with this adapted gimbal system. But now you can immediately imagine where it becomes complicated. On the marine chronometer, the entire watch mechanic moves, barrel, gears, escapement, but here it's only the escapement module. So how do you transfer the energy from the movement to this module if this one can freely move around as it pleases? Well, this is what you're about to find out, so hang in there, because we really try to make it as simple as possible.
On cherche constamment à avoir des précisions dans nos montres. Et de tout temps, un des ennemis de la précision, c'est que quand on varie la position de la montre, ça fait une légère variation de la marche. Le cœur vraiment de ce mouvement, c'est la cage qu'on voit ici. Le reste du mouvement est quelque part très très classique. Qu'est-ce qu'on voit? Donc on voit qu'il y a effectivement deux trains de rouage qui arrivent ici. Donc il y en a un qui amène l'énergie dans tout ce système. Maintenant, la particularité, c'est que cette boule va bouger dans tous les sens, alors que le reste du mouvement, pas. Donc, il faut coordonner ça. Si je prends, par exemple, dans un gyrotourbillon, on détermine même les mouvements. On tourne de manière régulière sur un axe ou deux. Ici, on ne sait pas. Donc, si vous voulez, on va capter une information des rotations par le deuxième rouage. Après, si vous voulez, dans le système qu'on a breveté, il y a une deuxième chose, c'est que on ne sait pas quand ça tourne dans ce sens et dans ce sens. C'est-à-dire le système corrige le résultat. Donc, sur le principe, qu'est-ce qui se passe? C'est qu'à un moment donné, on doit soustraire les mouvements de la cage à la partie, je dirais, du mouvement classique qui est influencée par ça. Pour expliquer ce qui se passe au niveau de ces petits rouages là, si vous voulez, le principe est assez simple. C'est sur le premier rouage, on inverse un mouvement. On voit, c'est-à-dire que quand ici je tourne dans un sens, à la sortie je tourne dans l'autre sens. Ça s'arrête là, c'est cette première partie ici. Donc qu'est-ce qui se passe maintenant? C'est que j'ai toujours ce système là qui est classique, mais après je vais m'agiter. Et si on veut, cette agitation va s'additionner à ce mouvement-là. Mais comme les rotations seules vont tourner dans un sens et que l'autre, je l'ai inversé, ça veut dire que quand j'ai des rotations, il va se passer ça. C'est-à-dire qu'elles sont annulées.
Okay, I hope you got most of it, and I warned you it was a bit geeky, but we just love it. In addition to that, I just wanted to mention that this module is made out of 61 components, and contrary to a tourbillon where you want the cage to be as light as possible, here you don't have this issue, and they would rather use sturdy material to make it as reliable as possible. But this implies that you have a lot of inertia. Think of the counterweight made out of solid gold. And this inertia has more and more influence as we get closer to the escapement. So that's the reason why they judge it would be better to counterbalance this with the use of a silicon wheel, which has a very low inertia and is crucial in the accuracy of your watch. Chronometric performance of the Academy Christophe Colomb is very high and superior to COSC standards. But they don't communicate too much about it because the way you measure this performance is by sound analysis of the escapement. And in this case, and because of the complex mechanic, well, you have quite a bit of parasite sounds that prevents normal instruments to correctly capture what is happening. That's the reason why Zenith used their own laser test to assess this performance. In terms of overall performance, it's very similar to the famous El Primero movement of the brand. The escapement beats at 36,000 beats per hour and has the same power reserve of more than 50 hours. We know they are working on some kind of evolution of this movement and this module in particular, so we can't wait to see what they come out with and when. So all the best to you, hope you enjoy this, and see you very soon.